Yo, what's up? This is DJ Pierre here chilling in Croatia on Top DJ Mag. Peace. You know what? I sort of don't feel like the father of acid house. I mean, I do, but then I don't. I don't really realize how much impact me, along with Spanky and the other members of Future, had on the house industry, you know? So I'm always reminded when I go places, people say, oh, you created acid and wow, you know, how did you do it and all that? And the way it happened wasn't planned. It wasn't like we really planned to do something. It just happened, you know. It's kind of like we stumbled upon something great. So all the all is kind of like, it's just weird. It's just like, I don't know, you know, it's just normal to me. What happened was Spanky, the founder of Future, he had bought the 303, and we didn't know how to work it. And he had it playing in his house, and he was like, you know, I can't get this thing to work right. It just keep making all these sounds and stuff and everything. But I think it sounds kind of interesting, he said. So I was like, wow. I was like, let me mess around with it. So I started turning the knobs and stuff. And next thing you know, we thought we liked what we were doing. And so from that point on, we just gave it to the guy that ran a music box. And his name was Ron Hardy. And he played it. And people kind of went crazy to it. So that's sort of how it started. So what happened was, we didn't really name it Acid Tracks. We, people just called it that. People would like come in and say, wow, you know, it's this new sound called Acid House. And I'm like, what is it? What is it? And the guy like have a song on tape. And this is before the record came out. So I was like, wow. I said, let me hear it. And I heard it. I was like, I said, man, that's our track. I said, that's not nobody else's track. We made that. So we was like, and we said, what are they calling it? And they said, they call it acid. So we thought, okay, well, we just named the song Acid Tracks. And then, but I hear the reason why it was called that was because people associated it with a drug because it was just so weird. It wasn't like, it was influenced by drugs. It just was strange. So they didn't know what else to compare it to, I guess. I used to deal with a label called Trax Records, and they would rip people off. They ripped Marshall Jefferson off, Larry Heard, Robert Owens, everybody who had anything to do with that label never got paid their royalties. So when I had got a deal with Jive Records, I promised I would never go back to that label in Chicago, and there wasn't any other labels in Chicago. So after a while, when I moved on from Jive Records, I decided to move to New York because I heard about Strictly Rhythm and a number of other labels out there, and I decided that I needed to be in the scene where the labels were, where the best clubs were, and I just wanted to be there so that I can catch the vibe of everything. So I decided to move. Strictly Rhythm, one thing about Strictly is when I first heard of them, I knew that I seen their records all over the record stores. So what happened was I went down there, and the guy that owns the label is really nice and everything. And one thing about the label is they pay royalties. So, you know, they were just real nice to me, took care of me. And in exchange, I gave them all my material, and we just had a good relationship. And they just revolutionized house music because they had all the best producers. Most of the biggest producers that came out of New York had at one time been on Strictly Rhythm, whether they started there or they did songs there after they had their first releases. So I would say Strictly Rhythm is probably the biggest influence, or has been the biggest influence in house music over the last like 8 years.